A very good morning, students. How are you all? I hope you all are taking a good care of yourself. So children, let us start today's mathematics class of grade 10th. Children, today I am going to begin with a new chapter, that is chapter number 14, statistics. And this is lecture number 1 of chapter 14. Children, this chapter is not new for you. You have learnt it in your previous classes also. So the topics which I am going to teach you today, they are, number 1, first of all I will make you understand the definition of statistics. After that I will explain you the difference between grouped and ungrouped data. Then we will be switching to central tendencies. After that I will explain you the concept of class mark. Then we will be switching to arithmetic mean for ungrouped as well as for grouped data. Today, one method of calculating arithmetic mean will be introduced, and the name of that method is direct method. And children, at the last, I will be explaining you few sums from exercise 15.1. in which I will make you understand how to calculate mean using direct method. Okay? So children, our first topic is, what do you mean by statistics? Please understand its definition carefully. Statistics is the study of collection organization here organization does not mean any firm organization means how to organize analysis interpretation and of course presentation of data. Let us understand what is the meaning of statistics. Statistics is the study of collection. First of all, we are going to collect the data. Then we are going to keep it in an organized manner. We are analyzing it. We are interpreting it. We are understanding it. And ultimately, we are going to present it in front of the others. Correct? So, statistics is the study of collection, organization, analysis, interpretation, and presentation of data. Now, from this definition, the question arises that what do you mean by data? So, children, I am going to explain you the definition of data. Data are nothing but the informations. Data are informations. What kind of information, children, we are going to include in data? Which are usually numerical. Usually numerical. Which are collected through observations. Through observations. Observations. So let us understand the definition of data now. Data is nothing but the information. What kind of information, children, it will be? It will be related to the numbers. Numerical information and which we are going to collect through observation. Like whatever is your observation, on the basis of that, whatever numerical values you are going to collect, that is known as data. So children, let us understand the definition of data through example. For example, suppose if I am a student of class 10th and my geography teacher told me to collect the data of the educated girls in a village. So definitely I will have to visit any village. Then I went in different houses to collect the data for the number of the girls who were educated, okay, and belonged to a particular family. So definitely that data I am going to collect in the form of numbers. So this is nothing but my observation only, right? So data are the informations usually numerical and which are collected through our observations. Got it? Now children, let us discuss the types of data. Number one, ungrouped data, and number two is grouped data. Children, related to ungrouped data, you calculated all the central tendencies like mean, mode, median in your class 9th. Okay, so in class 10th we will be dealing with grouped data only. So first of all, let us understand the difference between them. Ungrouped data is the data that are obtained in the original form, like it is nothing but a list of numbers. For example, so it is just a list of numbers. For example, 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 9 and so on. Okay. So ungrouped data is the data that obtained in the original form, means just a list of numbers. Correct? Let us talk about the grouped data. Grouped data is the data that has been organized in several groups. For example, 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15, 15 to 20, like in the same manner. Okay. So this is known as grouped data, in which the data has been organized in several groups. Here children, you can see that the difference between both of these numbers, this is actually known as a class interval. So difference between both the number is 5. So this is not essential that always the gap will be of 5. The data can be like this also, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40 and so on. Correct? So this is also known as grouped data. And this 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40 is known as class interval. Correct? In class interval, children, you can see that this, the lower number will be known as the lower limit, and this 20th, which is the bigger number in this interval 10 to 20 I am talking about, this is known as upper limit. Correct? And the difference between upper limit and lower limit will be known as class size. Correct? So what do you mean by class size? Upper limit minus lower limit. What is upper and lower limit? Here in this grouped data you can see that 10 is lower limit and 20 is upper limit. This is a class interval, and the difference between upper and lower limit will be known as class size. Okay children, so my next topic is central tendencies. There are three central tendencies which you have learned in class 9th also, that is mean, mode and median. So children, today I am going to explain you the very first central tendency, that is mean. You must be knowing about the term mean, that is arithmetic mean, or we can even call it average also. Fine. This is nothing but the average. First of all, I am going to make you recall how to calculate arithmetic mean or the average for the ungrouped data. Okay. For example, you will be having few numbers given, which are basically known as the observations which we have observed. Fine. Then how to calculate the mean or the average? This is sum of observations. Sum of observations divided by number of observations. Fine students, as I have just given you the example, suppose I visited in any village and I collected the data from each and every house of the educated girls. Correct? So that will be known as observation. So I am going to add all the observations, and suppose if I visited 10 houses, so number of observations will come 10. Correct? For example, x1, x2, x3 and up to xn. These are the observations, fine. And I am going to calculate their arithmetic mean. You know they are total n in number. So children, please be alert. X bar is the symbol to calculate mean. Formula you know. That is sum of all the observations divided by number of observations. Means x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus up to xn divided by n. So this is the way to calculate average or arithmetic mean when the data is ungrouped, like you will be having a list of numbers given. Fine. So children, out of three central tendencies, that is mean, mode and median, today I am going to explain you the concept of mean. Okay. Children, basically in your class 10th, as you know that we will be dealing with the grouped data. Okay. So there are three ways to calculate mean. Number one, direct method. Number two, assumed mean method. Assumed mean method. And number three is step deviation method. Fine. So today I am going to explain you how to calculate average when you will be having the grouped data given using direct method. Got it? So children, let us start exercise 14.1. I am going to read the very first question. Please be alert. A survey was conducted by a group of students as a part of their environment awareness program, in which they collected the following data regarding the number of plants in 20 houses in a locality. So what did they observe? They just observed the number of plants which were planted in 20 houses. Find the mean number of plants per house. How environment awareness program for students make environment healthy? So children, first of all, you will be having a table given. So that table I am going to construct over here. This is number of plants. So children, I can call it as my observation also, that I went in a locality in 20 houses. And what was my observation? That I went to observe the number of plants in those 20 houses. Fine. It is given in the form of grouped data. That is 0 to 2. Then 2 to 4. Then 4 to 6. Then 6 to 8. After that 8 to 10. Next is 10 to 12. And the last one is 12 to 14. Means number of plants from 0 to 2. You know that 0 is lower limit and 2 is upper limit. Okay. So children, let me tell you one thing, that whenever I am going to talk about this particular interval, that is 0 to 2, then you will have to include lower limit, but you are not going to include upper limit. So here, how many plants you are going to observe in the particular houses, that there is no plant means 0, or there is one plant. So 0 and 1 will be considered. If I am going to talk about next interval, then I have to include lower limit, that is 2 and 3 plants. Then here 4 will not be included as it is upper limit. Correct, students? So now in table I am going to write down number of houses. This is nothing but the frequency. What do you mean by frequency? Like 0 to 2 plants are occurring in how many houses? That is one house. Then 2 to 4 were there in 2 houses. Then 4 to 6 were in 1 house only. 6 to 8 were in 5 houses. Correct? 8 to 10, they were in 6 houses. 10 to 12 were in 2 houses. And 12 to 14 were in 3 houses. Clear, students? So let us match this data with pencil so that you can better understand it. So children, this is nothing but the frequency, means how many times the number of plants are going to be occur in these particular houses. Like 0 to 2 plants will be there, or you can say that 0 and 1 plant will be there in one house only. In the same manner, 2 to 4, 2 houses, 4 to 6, 1 house, and ultimately 12 to 14 plants were there in 3 houses. Correct? Now children, as in the question it is said that we have to calculate mean number of plants per house. So, and we are going to deal with what kind of data? This is grouped data. So for that, I am going to introduce one new term for you, that is class mark, though you have done it in your previous class also. Fine. So what do you mean by XI? XI is the symbol for showing class mark. And how do we calculate it? Please understand. Class mark, I can write here class mark, that is lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. This is the method to calculate class mark. Fine. So calculate it. You know lower limit is 0 and upper limit is 2. So add them. This is 0 plus 2 will become 2, and 2 divided by 2 is 1. Children, what is the need to calculate class mark? Actually, for each and every class interval, we require a point which would serve as the representative of the whole class. So here 1 is going to represent the whole class. For that, it is our assumption that the frequency of each class interval is centered around its midpoint. You know how to calculate the midpoint? You will be having two numbers given. You are going to calculate the midpoint, that is first number plus second number divided by 2. In the same manner, lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. So this is nothing but the midpoint for this particular class interval. Okay? Because it is assumed that the frequency of each class interval is centered around its midpoint. So that's why I am going to calculate the class mark while adding lower limit and upper limit and ultimately dividing it by 2. In the same manner, 2 plus 4 will give you 6. 6 divided by 2 will give you 3. Then 4 plus 6 is 10. 10 divided by 2, that is 5. 4, 6 plus 8 is 14. Again divided by 2, that is 7. Now 8 plus 10 is 18, then 9. Children, you can observe that these all are odd numbers occurring. 10 plus 12, 22 divided by 2 will be 11. 12 plus 14, 26 divided by 2 will be 13. So this is all about class mark. I have just told you that number of houses are nothing but frequency. So frequency I am going to represent by Fi. Correct? This is Xi. Now children, according to the formula of direct method, I want product of Xi and Fi. So I will be calculating Fi Xi. Here I, you can just count the number of observation 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I will start from 1 and will go up to 7 because total number of observations are 7. Okay. So let us multiply Fi and Xi. 1 into 1 will give you 1. 3 into 2 will give you 6, 5 into 1 will give you 5, 7 into 5 will give you 35, 6 9s are 54, 11 2s are 22, and 13 3s are will be 39. Correct? Now I am going to add this product, which is the product of Fi Xi. So children, for adding, I am going to represent it by sigma. Sigma is nothing but the summation. Okay. Summation, or here it is going to start from, you can say from 1 to 7 because there are total 7 observations. Or you can simply write sigma Fi Xi. Got it? So let us add them all. After adding, I have got 162. Clear? Now children, in the formula to calculate mean using direct method, I want sigma Fi as well. Sigma Fi is nothing but the summation of all the frequencies. So let us add them. They will be total 20 in number. So children, I told you that we represent mean by x bar. So the formula to calculate arithmetic mean or the average, when you will be having the grouped data given, first of all you have to calculate xi. After that you have to calculate the product of fi and xi. Fine. Then add the number of frequencies, that is actually sigma fi. And you have to calculate the summation of sigma fi xi. Okay. So the formula is sigma fi xi upon sigma fi. Got it? You can represent it by n also, that I told you in the formula when I calculated the mean in case of ungrouped data. That was sum of the observation divided by number of observations. So this is nothing but n only. Correct? So let us calculate it. 162 divided by 20. So cancel it. This is 2 tens of, this is 81. So 8.1 is the average, or you can call the arithmetic mean for the number of plants in 20 houses in the locality. Children, one thing I want to include here, that you do not consider I 1 to 7. Basically here we are going to count the number of houses, so they are total 20 in number. So I will be from 1 to 20. Instead of this you don't write, you can just write down sigma fi xi upon sigma fi. So this is the average, or you can say the arithmetic mean. Okay. So at the last you can write down that the required mean is, so mean is equal to 8.1. This is what actually, this is the number of the plants per house. Got it? Okay, one more thing is asked in this question. How environment awareness program for the student make environment healthy? So what answer you can write? That environment awareness program for the student make environment healthy, because as there will be more plants, so definitely there will be fresh and good environment. Fine. And definitely there will be no pollution occurring. Got it? One more thing is asked, that which method you are going to adopt to calculate mean and why. It is said here, you can see that we are going to calculate the direct mean method, because this is the simplest and the easiest method to calculate the average or the arithmetic mean. Now children, question number 2 is your maths homework. I am going to switch to question number 3. Please listen the statement carefully. The following distribution shows the daily pocket allowances of children of a locality. So the mean pocket allowance is rupees 18. This is given to us. Means in this question, we will be having mean given to us, and we are going to calculate the missing frequency. So let us start making the table. This is daily pocket money given to us. Daily pocket allowance, it will be in rupees only. Correct? So this is given to us 11 to 13. Then 13 to 15. Then 15 to 17. 17 to 19. 19 to 21. 21 to 23 and 23 to 25. And number of children who are going to get this pocket money, this is also given to us. So that is nothing but the frequency, number of children. So now I am going to write the number of children who are going to get pocket allowances in rupees every day. Okay, that is given. Children, those who are getting the money from 11 rupees, rupees 11 to rupees 13, they are 7 in number. Then for 13 to 15, they are 6 in number. 15 to 17 are 9 in number. 17 to 19 are 13 in number. 19 to 21 are T in number. 21 to 23, sorry, this is not T, this is F. 21 to 23 are 5 in number, and 23 to 25 are 4 in number. Correct, students? So this is nothing but the frequency. You can write here fi, as you know that we are going to deal with the grouped data and we are going to apply the direct method to calculate the mean. So for that we will have to calculate xi first of all. Xi you know that is lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. And after that we will be calculating fi xi. So this is lower limit is 11 and upper limit is 13. So 11 plus 13 divided by 2, that is 24 divided by 2 will give you 12. Got it? 13 plus 15 is 28 divided by 2 will give you 14. 15 plus 17, that will give you 32 divided by 2 will give you 16. And so on. Children, you know, you can observe that there is a gap of 2. So next will be 18. Next will be definitely 20. Next will be 22. Let us confirm for the last also whether we are calculating right or wrong. This is 23 plus 25 will give you 48 divided by 2 will give you 24. Correct. This is class mark. Now let us multiply them. 12 sevens are 84. 14 sixes are also 84. 16 nines are is 144. 18 into 13 will give you 234. 20 into F, that is 20F. Because children, in this question you will be having the average, or you can call it mean, is given to us, but we are supposed to calculate this missing frequency. Then 20 into 22 into 5 will give you 110. 24 into 4 will give you 96. So children, now I am going to calculate sigma fi xi, which is nothing but the summation of all this. So I will be adding 84 plus 84 plus 144 plus 234 plus 110 plus 96. So I have got 752 plus. This is 20F. This is present actually with variable. So it will be added separately. Correct? Now you know that according to the formula of calculating mean, we want sigma Fi as well. Means the sum of all the frequencies. So when I added them, I got 44 plus F. This F will be separately written and rest of the frequencies, their sum is 44. Got it? Now write down the formula of calculating mean. Mean is represented by X bar and the formula is sigma Fi Xi upon sigma Fi. Fine. Mean is given to us in the question. It is said that the average or the mean pocket allowance is rupees 18. This is given to us. So let us insert this value over here. This is 18. Sigma Fi Xi is 752 plus 20F upon sigma Fi is 44 plus F. Got it? Let us cross multiply. After cross multiplying, I have got 792, means when you multiply 44 by 18, you will be getting 792 plus 18F is equal to 752 plus 20F. So children, let us simplify it. This is 792 minus 752 will give you 40 is equal to 20F minus 18F, that is 2F. So it implies to F will be equal to 20. So our missing frequency is 20. Correct? So children, this was all about the direct method of calculating mean. Okay, now this is the time to get your mathematics homework. Do question number 2nd, 4th, 5th and 6th of exercise 14.1. These 4 questions you are supposed to do using direct method, which I have taught you today in your mathematics homework notebook, along with classwork questions, that is 1 and 3 of exercise 14.1. So children, that's it for the day. Thank you and have a nice day. Please like the video and do not forget to subscribe our channel.